interstellar space 6 years later. And I detect that both are still sending you data about their surroundings. Most impressive. What I find intriguing is that not only are your Voyagers receiving and sending data, they are also serving as ambassadors, carrying greetings from you Terrans to the universe. First detected your probes, we scanned them and discovered on board a golden disc containing sounds, images, and messages from the people of Terra, or Earth, as we learned you call it. Peter Quill has claimed that the most important item on the disc worth sharing with the universe is the musical message from your Terran, Chuck Berry. Processing this message, but am curious to know where Johnny is going, and is he being good? We were delighted to see an image of our Andromeda galaxy included on the Golden Record. Your Voyager's mission to be a calling card to the rest of the universe has already been a success. It is one of the reasons we are here at Epcot today.
Like in a roll, like a space.
No, that was fine.
The light casts moving shadows across the city, something Xandar is famous for. As the capital of the Nova Empire, Xandar is home to over 12 billion citizens. Constructed on a vast system of atolls, our city features a wide array of architectural styles, inspired by the many cultures and species who have traveled across the galaxy, called Xandar their home.
One of our more advanced projects is our APG, or Atoll Power Generation.
If you look closely at the Star Blaster's design, you might discover that its wings can flare out and form a star shape, resembling the Nova Corps logo.
The Nova Corps began with just 500 NASA searches and crews on Earth. Today, we operate as a massive universal peacekeeper. As you might expect, the Nova Corps maintains a strict dress code that reflects the rank, the highest of which is Nova Prime. Both Nova Corps and the Xandarian government are led by Nova Prime. This is our current prime,
You mean the plan that didn't go according to plan? We were completely outnumbered. In the end, though, we were able to defeat the rogue fleet. But we couldn't have done it without Quill.
That's right!
And here he is now, Peter Quill. What do you have to say about this?
It was really a group effort to execute my plan. Thank you, Gamora.
I would love to hear more about how Terra was chosen for this Wonders of Xandar tour.
Well, that was totally my idea. And Epcot, too, because I love that place. It's awesome. I went there as a kid, and I cannot wait to get to go back and ride Horizons. Also want to see the energy, the dinosaurs, and of course, hear the Veggie fruit. It's the best.
Okay, well, I'm sure it will be wonderful for you to relive all of those memories at the library. And it's thanks to the Guardians that Xandar is reaching out to other cultures across the galaxy. Xandar would have never survived the Kree battle were it not for the intervention of this ragtag team we know as the Guardians of the Galaxy. To uncover the true story, I spoke with the captain of the crew. Peter Quill, thank you for joining me today. The leader of your group was telling me about the plan to save Xandar from the Rogue crew.
Wait, did you say the leader? I'm the leader. Wait, who said that?
It was Rocket.
Well, don't believe anything Rocket says.
But he said it was your plan.
Well, okay. You can't believe that.
It was 12% of a party.
Maybe. Well, go on, introduce yourself.
Have you forgotten who I am? His brain is so fragile.
This is none other than Drax the Destroyer.
See? I mean, she knows who I am.
Anyways, I danced circles around the Kree dude until this same day.
You're weird and embarrassing, Dad. So it was a means of distraction. So then Rocket destroyed me.
Irani Rayan, Commander of the Nova Corps. On behalf of all Xandarians, I hope you have enjoyed exploring the wonders of Xandar. As you have seen, your world and ours were born of the same moment, one which you refer to as the Big Bang. As such, we are all galactic neighbors in a vast universe which we and countless others share. For you to travel to Xandar would take 2.5 million years, assuming you had a ship that could fly at the speed of light. So we decided to come to you. But even we could not have reached you so easily were it not for the Cosmic Generator, an advanced piece of Xandarian technology that creates jump points, artificial tunnels that act as shortcuts linking distant points in space. It is our desire to share this wondrous technology with your people so that together we might explore new worlds and create a brighter tomorrow. And now, as the culmination of the wonders of Xandar, you will be teleported to a Nova ship above your planet for a demonstration of the Cosmic Generator. I trust you will find it an unforgettable experience.
Welcome, people of Epcot. Epcotters. Epcotians. Citizens of Epcot. Does anyone know what they call themselves? What? I'm on? Someone needs to tell me what I'm on. Welcome. Epcot Terrans, I am Centurion Tal Merrick, and we're just about ready to teleport you up to the ship for the demonstration. As you're about to enter a secure Nova area, I must ask you to put away your Terran communication devices at this time. Recording of any type is strictly prohibited. I am very serious about this. Now, please step forward into the chamber. You're gonna love this.
Excellent.
What you see before you is the cosmic generator. And in just a few moments, we'll be activating it so you can experience for yourself what's happening.
I'm not sure. Our power's out. And the cosmic generator is gone.
Interior mod, go to code red. Prepare the fleet. And call the guardians. Now.
There's no cause for alarm. Turn off that alarm. I've got an important transmission coming in.
Hey, what's up, Nova Corp?
Our cosmic generator has been stolen.
What?
How?
What didn't we think of that? That thing's gotta be worth a fortune.
I am Groot.
Who do you think took it?
Perhaps that really big man outside your ship.
That is a big man. I need to alert Nova Prime.
I am watching drones from the arms.
That's not creepy at all.
This species has failed.
Wait, whoa. We didn't even know there was a test.
He's got the cosmic generator. And he's creating a new jump point.
Jump point to where?
Not where. When?
Some kind of mute jump point.
He's going back to the dawn of time.
Dawn of time, why?
To erase an error.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
Your time is over.
Wait, what do you mean? What do you mean that's so bad? Hey, Novadu, you know according to follow that whatever it is until we get there.
We can't. Our power is down, and I've got to get these Terrans out to evacuation shuttles.
I got it. I reprogrammed the shuttles to follow through the jump point.
What?
Look, they're our only chance of keeping track of that whack job until we get the cosmic generator back. Piece of cake.
What?
There's cake. Where's this cake?
That's impossible.
Yep.
But it's our only shot. Good luck.
Are you sure you can control it?
Come on, it's me! I got this.
We're all toast.
First it was cake, now there is toast. This plan is making me so hungry.
Terry, listen up. We need to make their way to the evacuation shuttles now. We'll follow the fleet if we get our power back. I mean, when we get our power back.
No.
This plan of the Guardians doesn't stand a chance. What? It's the on? What did I just say? You need to tell me when I'm on. Are you Terrans still there? Everything is under control. We're rebooting our subsystems and we'll have the power back soon. We do hope you enjoyed your brief visit with us. Over and out. Could this day get any worse?
pretty well, far. Perfect.
Cake toast.